Okay, so so today we will continue to talk about internal home, and then we will prove the theorem characterizing the module category in terms of algebras, as I say. Okay, so now we will provide, we will characterize the algebra object internal home 1-1 on for the module C over the category C de l'intensor product C hop. We will see that this algebra is fully called the canonical algebra, and that, by the way, there is an easy way to characterize this algebra object, the definition. So consider a multi-tensor category C as a C de l'int tensor product C hop module category. So as we already mentioned that, so as seen before, it is a category. Not categorification, a category generalization, generalization of the action by conjugation at the group level. So at the group level, you have the action by conjugation, and you can generalize this as taking C, the multi-tensor category C, as a module category over C, the intensor product C hop. Anyway, so, okay. So you consider this, and So over this module category, you consider the algebra object internal home 1-1. So in this category. And so as the one are unit of C. Okay, so this this object called it is called the canonical algebra. Canonical algebra of C. Okay. okay. So if we consider the previous example we mentioned yesterday about the finite dimension of algebra. So if you apply this construction to C equal rep H, so remark for C equal rep H as in previous example, so I mean this example here, So the algebra you get is still the dual, but as an algebra in the category of H bimodule, as an algebra object in the category of H bimodule. And call that C bimodule correspond to C up module. Okay, so that's okay for this mark. Now, we will write explicitly. There's a way to write this algebra object explicitly as follows. There is a way to write the algebra object label algebra object et explicitly. This is a this is stated as an example, but for me, it's more like a theorem. And we provide a proof. So let see. So explicitly in the fusion case. In fusion case, multi-fusion case. So let's see the multi-fusion category. And let O of C with a set of simple objects up to isomorphism. The set of simple objects up to isomorphism and consider A, the algebra object. Algebra object est equal home 1 in C tensor de l'intensor product C up as above. Then, in fact, A is equal or isomorphic. Let's say isomorphic to be sure to the direct sum of this simple object of C, X de l'intensor product, right dual of X. So this is as object of C, the intensor product C up. So you see, you can really write it explicitly. Ouf. Ouf. Ok, so. First, we have so consider this home space. So you consider this home space. So Y and Z are two objects of the category C. So let consider X. Let's see. X, Y, Z in O of C, I guess should be okay. Now you consider this home space. So you know there is a natural adjunction isomorphism, the usual natural adjunction isomorphism. Natural adjunction isomorphism. So moving, you can move the Z on the right. By taking the right, the left dual. Now, so the, so maybe it would be so X, Y, Z in C. So now, but Z star can be decomposed into simple components with multiplicities. So, so you don't need to care about that. Sorry about that. Okay, so this Z star. So, because you are in a multifusion category, it's very simple and finite. So every object decomposes as a finite direct sum of simple objects given together with its multiplicity. Okay. So you can inject, you can replace. Oh, c'est relou. Here, so you get so home C Y Z star the direct sum of X in of because the home functor is additive. X Z star. Okay. Now we will work on this guy. Now home C X Z star is so it's a natural adjunction isomorphism. X one again natural adjunction isomorphism. Z right dual X. Natural adjunction isomorphism. Now, okay, so now you can replace. We can rewrite that. So home C white answer Z1 is isomorphic to the direct sum X, the simple object. Home C Y X tensor, home the last thing to get, left right dual. Now consider. Now we will go to the Deligne tensor product. So you consider these two. So it's isomorphic to the direct sum of X in OC of the Deligne tensor product C. And here, yeah, here there is a point I'm missing the details here. So let me write this as an exercise. Why should we put off here? Off, so x, y, z to x, right dual. So up to these details here, not like that. Why should we put a hop here? Otherwise, it's okay. So you get y z. And similarly, you have this and this. Go to this and this. Okay. So this is more or less the definition of the home space for the Deligne tensor product. Okay. And so then you can put the direct sum inside, and it's om C, the tensor product C up of, because then y and z do not depend on x, and direct sum x in of x, the tensor product right dual of x. Okay, so now you can apply. Now we are in the category C, the Deligne tensor product C hop, which is also a multi-tensor category. You can apply a finite multi-tensor category here. You see it's right also. So we can apply the definition of internal home here in this category. So by the natural isomorphism from definition of internal home, you can so this, if you consider, so this y like that, internal home 1 1. So what is that? By definition, there is a natural isomorphism like that home C. So C now is here is a module over C, C, C hop, like that. Y, C, so one, one. And by definition, so this here is nothing but y tensor z. So home c y tensor z one. Okay, so you see you have so where is it? Okay, so you have that. You have that equal to that. But as, yeah, equal to that. So you have this one isomorphic to this one. Okay. And this is true for every YZ. So you don't need to care about YZ. So then you can get an isomorphism for what is inside by Yoneda-Lemma. So by Yoneda-Lemma. Home internal home one is isomorphic to the direction. And this is what we wanted to prove. Okay. Okay. So let me maybe write. I don't know if putting such a color help, but okay. So we started from here. Let's see. We have this one, which is the same here. We came back to this one. This one, the same as this one, same color. This one is the same as this one. So we can have an isomorphism between these two. Okay, so that's all for this theorem. Theorem exercise. So in this example of module, you take a multifusion category. I guess you should maybe take it fine. I'm not mistaken, we assume something to be finite in the previous subsection. And we said it can be done for without assuming finite, but I guess it's, yeah. Anyway, we are mainly interested in the finite. Yeah, okay. No, fusion is all about it. So we don't need that.
Multifusion is already finite.
Okay, so it's okay. Okay, so
so now what about
so there is also a way to write the multiplication on A explicitly, more or less explicitly. So A equal internal home 1 1, which is isomorphic to, as we said, we just proved like that. Right, your A tensor A tensor A is isomorphic to just take the tensor product of A above X tensor Y radial of X tensor Y. So now so consider the pairing So you have home C X tensor Y Z home C Z X tensor Y. We make a pairing. You start from Z, you go to X tensor Y, and then you, no, the other way around. Start from Z, you go to X tensor Y, and then you come back to Z. So you have this natural map like that, from Z to Z, like composing these two. And Z is assumed simple here. C Z is taken simple. So so let I'm sure right maybe take Z like that. So Z simple. Okay. And this map here is surjective. Now but this home space there is a natural adjunction isomorphism. In fact, you make two natural adjunction isomorphism. So you get an isomorphism here. Natural adjunction isomorphism. And okay. So
So you can replace this one by this one, and then we get a map. So then we get, so we can make, we can so you put this here, and then you can deduce a map in the C, the intensor product C hop, as we did before. So then, so we get a map. From C tensor C hop of X tensor Y, value of X tensor Y to Z right dual of C, from that to K. Okay. Then consider the canonical morphism in above home like that. So it's not completely clear what they mean by the canonical, but I guess the one, assuming there is one, mapping to one in K. So as I said, this is surjective. So so it's not completely clear here, but I guess in fact we just need one. Maybe I should write a listing of the canonical. Okay. And so we have an explicit morphism here. And we have such morphism for every Z. And so this is this morphism we will use to give an explicit way to give the explicit multiplication morphism. So you can decompose, you have so what we did provide. So you by making some tensor by diaxon, you get a map from A tensor A to A. And so the point here is the multiplication morphism A tensor A to A is a direct sum over Z in and also X, I guess, Y, I don't know what is A Yeah, so A is written. Of such above morphism. So by above morphism, I guess I mean that one. With another color. So this is a way to write more or less explicitly the multiplication morphism in this case. Okay, so now we can go to new subsection characterization of module category in terms of algebra. Term of algebra object. So this, as I said, this will be this subsection is dedicated to characterize the C-module category as mod CA. Characterize C module category as mod C A in some good case. A equal internal home of some object in M. So here is the statement explicitly. So let's see, be a finite multi-tensor category. The term is the following theorem. So let M be a C-module category. And let M in M be an object satisfying some properties, and we will see later that we can all in some good case we can always find such an object. So one corollary will be that that any C module category is of this form. C module category which are I don't remember. Some good C-module category. So such that, consider an object M such that the functor home is exact. Recall. So we already know that it is automatically left exact. Just need to assume here to be right exact. That it is automatically left exact. So only need to assume right exact here. Okay. And second point. So we need in some sense that this object M generate the category M as a C module category. In other words, for all N in M, there exists X in C and the morphism which is a surjection. So it's written surjection in the book, but I guess I mean epimorphism. So in other words, M generate M as C module category. Okay. So if you have that, then if you consider this algebra object, internal home MM, then the functor F from M to mod C et N map to home internal home M and N. So we already mentioned this functor yesterday. So we already know that this is really a module. Yeah. Over home MM, A equal home MM, internal home MM. So this functor is an equivalent. Is an equivalence of C module category. Mentioned yesterday. Okay. So this is a main theorem. Today. So we can make the pause. And we will consider the proof of this theorem after the pause. Pause. Okay. Ça marche? So, what about the proof of this important theorem? So, proof. So the proof will require several steps. So we will write this step as a claim. So we will prove, three claims. So the point here is to prove that we have an equivalence of category. So so the functor is already a C-module functor. So we need it to be an equivalence of category. So we need to prove that. There is a way to characterize equivalence of category in terms of, if you remember, it is enough to prove that the functor is fully faithful. So this is a property about the home space and essentially surjective, which is a property about the object. As long as you prove that, you get this functor is an equivalence of KTO. So we will essentially, the step will be to prove these two fully faithful and essentially surjective. So the proof will require several step claims. So first, so let me write it next page. First claim. So the map, so we have a map. So the map, the first and second claim will be about home space, and the third claim will be about object. The map F from home space N1, N2 to home A. So remember that in this category, the home space is given by the what we wrote home A, so the morphism of A module. F, so this functor fn1 fn2 is an isomorphism for every n2 in M and n1 of the form. So we, for the first step, we need to consider N1 on some specific form of the form X tensor M. So M, this is the usual M, and M this M. And the M in the statement, as in the statement of the theorem. Okay. Not as, but exactly in fact, the M in the statement. M from the statement of the theorem, so an object of M. Okay, so need to prove that. So this is more or less what we call fully faithful, but here we need to, as a first step, we need to assume that N2 is of the form X tensor M. Okay. So proof of the first claim. So consider the natural isomorphism 3 from previous lemma. So let me recall this from previous lemma. So so this natural isomorphism, do you remember there is a list of 4 natural isomorphisms involving internal home? And we need this one here, M1 extensor M2 natural isomorphism. You put the X outside M1, M2. So this one. Okay.
Now you consider f of n1, this object, which is by definition homme m, and here there is a mistake in my note. M n 1. Ah no, it's okay. So which is m n1, which is, because n1 is of the form xm, m xm, and you apply the I will write this here, which is just no, not like that. Wait, XM. So this is just N1. Okay. So this is isomorphic. So you apply this natural isomorphism just here. So you put the x outside, and it's home, internal home, m and m, m m. So this is just internal home m m. So this is just x tensor A. Okay. Okay, so we will use then the claim reduce to the following calculation. So we will make some calculation involving natural isomorphism, natural adjunction isomorphism, or the definition of internal home. and we will get what we want. So you start from home A, Fn1, Fn2. So this is by using this equal this, you get that this is equal to A extensor A f of n2. But this is isomorphic to, so we already saw that the lemma before. By a lemma. Mentioned before. So you to go from home space over A and home space over C. So the lemma 7, 8, 12 in the book. So the point is that you can remove this tensor A and replace here A by C. So we saw that. So this is natural isomorphism like that. X, F, N2. Okay. So this is equal to internal home m n2. So this is equal to home c x internal home
M and 2. And by definition of internal home, this is equal to home over the C module category X tensor M and 2. So it is equal to, because X tensor M is N1, home, so there is a, this is equal to home N1 and 2. So we went from here to here only by some natural isomorphism. So exercise here to show that above composition is above composition of isomorphism is the inverse of F, or maybe what's the name of that? The functor you use to get an equivalence, so it's not necessarily an isomorphism. Here you just need, so inverse of M at the level of home space, not as a functor, but inverse of M, I mean at the level of home space, for home space. It's not the inverse functor. Okay, so then we get that F is fully faithful, assuming, in some sense, assuming something about that. Now, second step, we want to prove that without any assumption of N2, which will mean that F is really fully faithful. So, so second step, the map F from home, so same thing as before, without any assumption of N2 on N2, Fn1, Fn2 is an isomorphism for whole object N1 and 2 in the C module category M. So proof of 2. So by condition so two is this two here we have this surjection, so we will consider a surjection for n equal n one. We have, there exists X in C and an epimorphism like that. Let's call S. Okay. But in abelian category, S is an epimorphism if and only if we have this exact sequence if this sequence is exact. So you had 1, 0 here. So this is okay, well known in abelian category theory. Now consider the kern. Consider K to be the kernel kernel of S. So the kernel, you will consider the kernel of this this morphism. So you have K X M S N 1 0, and now apply the assumption 2 again. So we get we get an epimorphism so exist then exist. So we apply the 2 for K. So we get an epimorphism. We get another. We get Y in C and an epimorphism Y tensor M S prime to K. Okay. And so we have Y tensor M. So we go S prime to K. We go here to X tensor M. So this is K composed with S prime. And then N1 and 0. And so, but the image of K of that is K itself. So it's equal to the kernel of S equal to K. So this, so above, so the sequence above sequence this sequence here, and by this sequence I just mean this arrow. I don't consider this part. So this sequence is exact by definition. We know that this is exact. So this part is exact, and we added that, but this is exact also. So it is exact. So above sequence is exact. It's exact. Okay. So you get something exact. Now, Now, by by condition one, the functor f is exact. So you can apply the functor f to the sequence star, it keep exactness by definition of exact functor. So the sequence f of y tensor m, f of x tensor m, f to n1, 0 is exact. And this will be called the sequence with double star, like that. And let me put it here. Okay. So this is exact also by the assumption one here. The functor is exact. And remember that this functor is exactly f. So it's okay. Okay, so now so now we need to consider a big diagram. So now consider the following commuting diagram. So we will put two, so 0, 0, 0, 0. So we put this 0 because we want to apply what is called the 5 lemma. So I will not recall what is 5 lemma, but it's very usual. It's very well known in category theory. And to get 5 lemma, we will need to add this 0. So, and then we will apply the functor ohm, so we will apply ohm m like that to that and that. So we apply that and we get ohm m N1, N2. In fact, we apply it just for the first. So the second, which will be ohm A. Ohm M X M N2 tensor M. M Y tensor M N2. And here ohm so ohm M. So in the book it's written ohm M. But initially, I was thinking it should be ohm A, but in fact, ohm A is included in ohm M. So we can write ohm M directly. it's okay. Fn2. So just let me write that. Home A is including home M. So even if the functor, the image of the of this map is home A, in fact, you can, so home A is a subset of home M, so you can just write home M. Okay, and here, because in fact we need to apply the left exact functor home M. Okay, home M F extensor M N2. M F Y tensor M M F tensor N2. Okay. But this functor is left exact. Is left exact. So the row above are exact. Applying. This two star and double star. Okay. Now. In fact, I have a doubt here because we need F to be isomorphic. So we need A here. So I want to write, I want to fix something. Because we want, in fact, what we need is A, not M here. So I guess, I hope I'm, I guess, so we apply home M to star. So let me, where is it? Ah yeah, because you reverse the arrow. You reverse the arrow. but okay, so right. So I guess so. I guess home A. Is left exact also. So I need to check that. So the first row above is exact. Second robot is exact. Yeah. guess it's better like that. So we need to check that. Check. Okay. So apply. To this, yeah, apply to this one. Okay, so we have this is exact, this is exact, this are isomorphism, and so by the part one of the proof, they are isomorphism, so we can apply the five lemma to get isomorphism. Where? 1, 2, 1, 2, this one. Next, so as I said, so by the part one, the two last vertical arrow are isomorphism here. This one is infinite isomorphism because we are exactly in the case of the part one. N1 is of the form X tensor M. Part one. Yeah. N1 is of this form. So we can apply here. We get the expected isomorphism. So it's isomorphism. And this one are trivially isomorphism because it's zero, not to zero. Trivially, the two first one are also isomorphism. Conclusion, by five lemma, so I don't recall what is five lemma, it's well-known lemma from category theory. Five lemma mean because we have five, you have five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you know something from the two on the left, the two on the right, and you deduce something for the one in the middle. So by five lemma, the arrow in the middle is also an isomorphism. Okay, as expected. So F is fully faithful. Now we want it to be surjective. And I guess I will have no time. I will start. I have 10 minutes. I will see what I can do in 10 minutes. So the functor, the last claim, the functor F is surjective on isomorphism class of object of mod CA. So in other words, it is essentially surjective. The proof of that. So before, so we need to recall a statement. Recall a statement involving surjection, but in mod CA. So we have the same thing with surjection with mod CA. Recall the following statement. So which is exercise 8, 7, 8, 14 in the book from the previous section, from the section about algebra on multi-tensor category, the previous section, some previous section. For all L in mod, so we have essentially the same thing. There exists X in C and a surjection, an epimorphism, extensor A to L. Okay. Now, just as before, what we did with the previous surjection. So you have that, you have the surjection, you have this exact sequence. And then you can do the same thing just as before. So you have other surjection to the kernel, to X tensor A, S, L, zero. So you get the exact sequence Y A X A L zero. Now, so take, so you define this composition K compose with S prime, you call it F tilde. Okay, and now we will consider the image of this morphism F tilde through another composition of natural isomorphism. So consider F, the image of F tilde by the following composition of isomorphism let me try to do as much as I can. So home A white tensor A, X tensor A. So this is, so we will consider here just the the C module functor structure. So F white tensor M, F X tensor M. So you go from one to the other. because f, f is psi module functor plus the fact that f of m is precisely a. So you can put f, you can put the y outside, and it remains f of m, which is a. Okay, and you get the isomorphism from the part one of the proof. From the one of the proof, from m y tensor m x tensor m. So you consider, so you know f, so f is a morphism from that to that. So it's here. And you consider this isomorphism and this isomorphism, you get a map. So this is f tilde, and you get f here. F is here, F tilde is here, and F is here. Okay. So I have no time to finish. It's almost done, but so I will finish that next week, but I can just say without writing. No, I cannot say. So we should write. So I guess I will restart from this next week. So next week I will reread quickly. I will reread from here, and then I will finish. Because I have no time, so end of session. So we will finish, we will prove that there is a way to write. So we started from So we started from L, so we took L. We started from some L, and then we will find some N such that L is isomorphic to F of N, which means that the functor is essentially surjective. Okay, so we see. Yeah. So we will finish the proof next. This is end of session. Okay.